Hello, boys and girls. I am once again trying to find my way inside the void. And it has been very, very long time since I played this. I think my last recording was from summer, and I kind of stopped at the point where I wasn't sure how to play anymore. Difficulty. Well, basically, I couldn't figure out how to solve the stuff.
I'll be your guide. Don't fear death. There is no death in the void.
And
don't fear death. There is no death in the void.
And during my last play, or was it earlier? There was this this thingy. Okay, here they're called hearts, the pieces of yourself that you collect. One heart that I never knew how to get because it was somewhere high up, and glyphs. some of the glyphs that I had tried, I hadn't worked on that. So I looked it up, and it turned out that I needed to use that magnet thingy, which I had tried, but not at the right angle. So when I painted that correct figure into the air, the heart came gliding down, and now I have another weaponized squiggle in my inventory. Well, knowledge base, library, whatever. And I also kind of figured out the sequence for chamber visits. So as soon as I don't want to exit yet. As soon as I'm done harvesting these pretties here, and I always leave a little bit behind. I don't know if it's helping any,
but will come to you soon.
It will make me feel better.
Riches will come to you soon.
As far as the pretty factor goes, this would certainly be a game for the what you play when you're high serious. But the level of planning and strategizing and all that is way too complex for that. The same point where I ended my last recording. I mean, chronologically. But I have made some different choices. Well, for one, I grabbed that heart that I couldn't before. Then.
Don't fear death. There is no death in the void.
I defeated that brother that I did last time. Well, basically I defeated him again, and I have made some notes about well, mental notes about the other.
I will bring you luck.
The other guardians.
No regrets.
So it would appear that most of them. Most of them are only vulnerable at certain times during the battle. So if I'm just spamming color around, then that doesn't do much. But you sort of have to get to know them. Okay, I will leave the little tea cozy fellers alone. Let's check my equipment here. I'm gonna load myself up. Very much right now because I'm about to visit the that elder sister who was supposed to provide useful insight and stuff. And she wants green and blue, but also in her chamber is the little devil who wants crimson and amber. So I'm gonna have to hang around a little bit. Is this all? I think I have more. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, is it 16? I think it should be 16 by now. Let's see. Yep. So I obtained this one.
Ordalia. With this glyph, a brother can mark a fellow brother as a blasphemous traitor, challenging him to a duel. After drawing this glyph on a brother suspected of heresy, the battle begins immediately and ends only when one of them dies.
So this is the one that I obtained from that guy who has face for ass. I think his name was Whaler. And this...
Hawk. This glyph creates an obedient golem out of sharp twigs. After coming to life, the golem rises into the air and waits until its creator marks a target with color, at which point it rushes to the target and pierces it. The more color the hawk is charged with, the farther it sees and the more damage it does on collision.
So this is the one that I got from Una's mine, the one that I had to drag down. Let's see what else we got here. This is the one that the little devil gave me.
This glyph is the opposite of donor. It compels a sister to give you the color she's keeping in her last heart. When the color floods the sister's chambers, she will lose strength and may close the road through her realm.
What is this? Okay. Yes, so 16, and I think I've got them full, well, almost full, close enough. Filled up the green one. Okay, let's go inside. So I take it if one of the bladders on the left gets full and the color starts leaking out, then it's wasteful. Hello there. Oh, I need to change my attire now. Put back the green. Stuffed with bling bling, then apparently I'm more trustworthy. And again, I can't remember if this is something I read from other users, but I think it was important not only the absolute amount the color that you have, but also the relative amount. So it's if I take away everything else, then the gold ratio is really, really sweet. Okay, let's talk. I can't remember much. I would get her like completely free.
None of us knows how to grow color. The Brother Keepers devour it and hold it hostage, and color suffers, and brings suffering to them, burning their insides. We, the sisters, devour Nerva. It feeds us. But we can't use it here. Our chains prevent us from action. Only you can grow color, kind guest. It's your nature to try to pass our entire world through your body.
Let's see now. that quite soon I'm gonna have to face a challenge from yet another brother. So I better speed up the metabolism. I want to be able to fill this side too when it comes to fighting, but at the same time I will have to digest some to get this side filled as well. So I might be squandering my resources right now, but hey. Except now I'm not sure what to do next. I know I will have to... Oh yeah, I will have to go to the youngest or the sister death's chamber at some point and check out the new predators after she checked out. Place of them all here. Okay. Let's go back. And let's go back to her. One thing that I want to know is If I open up all the chambers... Yes, I saw you. If I open up all the chambers, will there be some sort of shortcuts, maybe? Okay, what's the heart situation? Gold and violet. I don't think I have nearly enough for her. So, wait. I can still produce more green. So I guess this is supposed to be very close to the base reality, if there is such a thing in this game. Again. Should probably harvest some shit while I'm here. At least there aren't any predators here yet. That's great. Okay, so I'm down to one green. And I leave a little bit behind. So I haven't planted this one. Let's see if how much gold. Not enough. Maybe later. I wonder if I open the second hearts of these jailbait girls, then will their gardens sort of merge? Because it's basically the same garden, only she has it with clear sky at night, and the girl on the swing has it sort of a golden fog in daytime. Otherwise the layouts are similar, and that clockwork tree in the middle, that's the same too. These little buggers are here. Oh wow. I'm starting to get it. Maybe later on I would have to draw a certain glyph from this position, or from the position of the other bench. I don't know. Okay, little buggers. Time to eat. This is a pretty good place to eat, if you ask me. Let's check. This one. Actually, I need more open ground, because the grass there might get distracting. What? Don't go. Take another one. Promise. Come. Oh, I picked it up again. Okay, now I get it. Wait. Damn it. Okay, now I'm wasting stuff. Time to load. Oh yeah, here we go. I wasn't sure how much green I had on me. Thank you.
I am the color of your power and fame.
I'm pretty sure that clock wasn't ticking before. I mean, before I planted stuff in this garden. Gold. Whoa, what do we have here? I know that there will be some sort of deal with the golden apples, because the sister who has been calling out for me since the beginning of the game mentioned something about fetching golden apples. Okay, let's plant another golden tree. Whoa! Oh, these are the color bubbles that dance around. Now then, I need this to influence stuff. Process a little, in which case I'm gonna put back this. No, come on. For such a simple game, it has sometimes very frustrating levels of precision that are required. Very frustrating. Especially this biggest heart. It's kind of hard to tap. Actually, I just want to process. A wee bit of violet goes a long way, apparently. Let me plant a green tree, another green tree then as well. The little buggers stuff now again. Damn it. Okay, at least I got the tea cozies. These ones I can lure with one drop. They are not too far. Usually they are. Come on! Oh yeah. Whoa! Ah, there's one more tea cozy there. I guess I can just leave them be. Because even if some guardian or brother comes and... Oh yeah, they can't pick this one up again. Even if they come to exploit the garden, they won't be able to catch the little buggers. Chamber to spare that I will plant another tree here. Yeah, this also filled up much faster than green. Okie dokie. Let's see. Nearly enough to fill her up because I didn't exactly overflow with kindness before. Thank you. secret passageway behind the bookshelf for all the trouble I'm going through. Is this lab coat? I think it is. Even with all the gold here, I don't think I have enough. About 100. Blue. Okay, almost halfway there. And I wonder if my current resources... Oh yeah, I think I can process this into some quality stuff. Which means I'll have to hang up there. I could check out the garden. It's another thing that's kind of wonderful and at the same time frustrating about this game is that... Oh no, I can use that one later. Is that while you're running against time, at the same time you have to allow some time to pause. And I have noticed that many great games tend to have this sort of built-in dilemma. Except I don't think he wants to be challenged.